clear the garage, please. Car's ready to leave. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining.
1 history. They came close five times in 1978, 1980, 81, 85, 1997. Managed to finish 81% of his races on the podium in 2021. Still though, Michael Schumacher holds the record for highest percentage, winning 2000.
Everyone ready? Okay, let's go. There's 2 minutes left in this session and we're in the drop zone. We need a quick lap or that's qualifying over for us.
British constructor Arrows never won a race after 383 attempts, the highest of any team in Formula One history. They came close five times in 1978, 1980, 81, 85, 1997. Sebastian Vettel holds the F1 record for the shortest time elapsed before picking up a penalty. He was caught speeding in the pit lane in practice for the 2006 Turkish Grand Prix almost immediately after he exited the garage, just 9 seconds into his F1 career. The inaugural World Drivers' Championship was held in 1950 during the fourth season of F1. Giuseppe Farina, who was driving for Alfa Romeo, took the championship after winning three of the seven races held that season. Juan Manuel Fangio also took three victories but lost out points after having retired from the other three races he entered. One of the longest broadcasted races was also one of the shortest. The 2021 Belgian Grand Prix lasted only 3 minutes and 27 seconds, the race being flagged due to wet weather conditions on lap 3. Max Verstappen managed to finish 81% of his races on the podium in 2021. Still though, Michael Schumacher holds the record. We'll be right back. affectionately known as... total weight. F1's distinctive sound throughout the decades is in part due to the high revving engines in use. F1 engines joined the V8 era in the mid-2000s, for example, could reach 19,000 RPM. In comparison, a typical road car won't exceed around 6,000 RPM. The Nürburgring is the only F1 track to have hosted three different races: the German Grand Prix, European Grand Prix, and Luxembourg Grand Prix. We might be used to blisteringly fast pit stops, some even approaching the sub 2 second mark, but what about the longest? Well, that would go to Valtteri Bottas, who had to retire after a seized wheel nut forced him to retire in the 2021 Monaco GP. The seized nut was removed 43 hours later, which officially makes it the longest pit stop turnaround in history. It's almost a given that the drivers on the grid today were kart racing as children, so they could enter the sport with as much experience as possible. It hasn't always been like that though. In the 1950s, the average age of the drivers was 39, with three over the age of 50. Sebastian Vettel holds the F1 record for the shortest time elapsed before picking up a penalty. He was caught speeding in the pit lane in practice for the 2006 Turkish Grand Prix almost immediately after he exited the garage, just 9 seconds into his F1 career. Hello to everyone here and welcome, and a special shout out to our VIP guests, Lars Hammer and Arthur Jackman, affectionately known as the Jackhammer. Let's hope we see a good effort from McLaren here today. In recent times, they've fallen to somewhat of a midfield team. The last time the constructor won a world championship was in 1998. The United Kingdom has achieved more World Drivers' Championships than any other country, over a quarter of which were won by Lewis Hamilton. Ferrari are the only team to have raced in every single season in Formula One. Max Verstappen managed to finish 81% of his races on the podium in 2021. Still though, Michael Schumacher holds the record for highest percentage when in 2002, Schumacher finished on the podium in every race he participated in, making it 100%. F1's distinctive sound throughout the decades is in part due to the high revving engines in use. F1 engines joined the V8 era in the mid-2000s, for example, could reach 19,000 RPM. In comparison, a typical road car won't exceed around 6,000 RPM. 2014 ushered in a new set of regulations that saw us enter the turbo hybrid era.